Hey everyone, nothing quite strikes fear into the heart of us than the front panel connectors. They're often not spoken about or shown on fancy, flashy PC builds for some reason. Probably because when you actually try plugging them in, your motherboard isn't ready in the case and you're kind of going like this. And then when you actually go to turn your computer on, it doesn't work because you've got everything wrong. Some motherboards make it slightly easier by actually labelling where to put everything on the motherboard, but it's still a complete pain. And I'm going to start acting.
I just wish there was another way.
Wow. Nailed it. So this is the Gigabyte G Connector. I actually originally thought it was called the 8 Connector when I first looked at it, but it is definitely the G Connector. And what this actually does is it plugs into your Gigabyte motherboard and it's meant to make everything a lot easier when it comes to the front panel connectors. So in this video, I just want to show through what exactly the Gigabyte G Connector is and how it helps your front panel connector connections and things like that. So the first thing I should say is you don't actually need this. It's purely a guide. It's just a pass-through. There's nothing magic about this. It just helps you put things in. So the way that this Gigabyte G Connector works is that it has little labels on it for everything that you need. And basically, if you've already got cables in there, there's little clips that you just have to pull up. There, you pull up and it'll actually come out there. Okay, so the way this works is you get your cables and you plug them into the right bit. So this says power switch, so plug that in, and in this case the polarity doesn't matter, so it can be either direction. I've then got my power LEDs and the polarity does matter, so you've got plus needs to go there and minus needs to go there. So let's try and plug that in that way. There we are. So plug that in, and again you get a click, so that's in. And then the last one is going to be my hard drive LED, which is the one over here, and again, polarity doesn't matter as much with this. Well, I've got all my cables jumbled, haven't I? That's a good start. So, hard drive, plus and minus, polarity doesn't matter as much. Let's just get that in. And click that. And that is now done. Clicked in. Good. So that is it for my front panel connectors, because the other ones on the case, this is not a reset button, it's actually for LEDs. Then my USB and my HD audio go somewhere else. So that's it for my actual front panel connectors. So I've got it all connected up, quite easy, quite straightforward. I haven't got speakers, I haven't got chassis intrusion or reset button. And then when you come to plug it in, you just need to make sure you plug it in the right way. So I know that my hard drive is down here, based on looking at the motherboard, so I can just plug it in there, and I'm done. And that's it really. It's quite a simple connector. It doesn't seem like it does much, and you can skip it entirely. But it does just make things a bit easier and it stops you from pulling loads of weird faces like I usually do when I'm actually doing my front panel connectors. So I hope you enjoyed this video and found it useful. If you did, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.